Hello everyone, we are group 9 individual. We are going to present the insight that we find more interesting from the data on COVID-19 coronavirus by our work in data. First, let's introduce the data set that we use in the data analysis. The complete data set is a collection of the COVID-19 data maintained by our work in data. As they note with the data set, the mission of our work in data is to make data and research on the world's largest problem understandable and accessible so that this data set is completely available for the contribution as the CSV XLSX JSON files on the GitHub repository. The following initial step that we do to understand the data set is the phase of data exploration. There is a brief information about the data set. The main types of variable are objects and false number. The data is 167,000, which contain the data on each day for each country from 2019 until the beginning of this year. And the data column represented a set of information that is confirmed case and confirmed death, hospitalization and intensive care unit ICU admission, testing for COVID-19, vaccination against COVID-19, reproduction rate, policy response, other variables such as continent, location, days of observation, and population density.
In the data preparation, we have the three most important things to deal with. First of all, filter the data. We filter the data from the data set by the country that we are interested in and the features that could be used for the analysis. We decided to focus on our neighboring countries, which are Cambodia, Laos, Malaysia, Thailand, and Myanmar. The second one is the data format. Date and time data is collected in a format that is difficult to use, so we change the format of the object to be in the date time data frame. Last but not least is the missing value. This missing value we consider as the data that we can use the data from other features to fill. For example, most of the total value can be filled with the calculation of the new value plus the previous total number. And for the other features that cannot be calculated, we either fill them with the previous data or drop the column. And for the data visualization, there are four factors to focus, including vaccination per 100, death case, stringency index, and new cases. We plot the line graph to see the relationship in each month to compare the value in each month. As can be seen in the left-hand side graph, the relationship between vaccinated in each month in the year 2021 for that the number in each country increased from July to October and dropped down after November. And on the right hand side, there is a relationship between the high value of this case in August because it is the early stage of vaccination for people. However, a month after people got vaccinated, the number of death cases decreases. And next is the relationship between stringency index in each country show that countries with the most stringent epidemic measures are countries with the high stringency index. So this point in the country with a high stringency index, such as Thailand, Myanmar, and Malaysia, there are new cases that have decreased.
The next part is machine learning. The goal that we set gradually from what we have done to predict the new case that could happen in the future. We will get the insight from three machine learning models that we have selected for predicting new case in Thailand, which are the multiple linear regression, the support vector regression, and the short-term model. Then we will select the best model by them performance evaluation derived from mean square error and R square. As a result, this study found that each model has a different performance evaluation. This slide represents the performance of multiple linear regression. The value of the thesis definitely increased according to the number of data. However, this model showed an MSE value, which is around 100 million. This slide represents the performance of support vector regression. The MSE of this test set is quite bad, and the value of each data in the test set is too similar. We assume that the data set that we use for the machine learning might be too big, so the performance of this model might not be efficient enough. The last one is long short tail model. The reason that this model can be adjusted to get the best performance is that this model has the lowest MSE, unlike the multiple linear regression and support vector regression. And that brings us to the end of the data analysis presentation. We hope that the insight that we have found could some way provide benefit to the listener. Thank you.